Welcome to a series of videos on trigonometric identities. This video will review the reciprocal, quotient, and Pythagorean identities, and the goal is to use these identities to determine function values. The reciprocal identities, cosecant theta is equal to 1 over sine theta, secant theta is equal to 1 over cosine theta, and cotangent theta is equal to 1 over tangent theta. And the quotient identities, tangent theta is equal to sine theta divided by cosine theta, and lastly, cotangent theta is equal to cosine theta over sine theta. Now, we've already discussed these earlier in the semester, so we're going to go ahead and move along to the Pythagorean identities, but we will use these in some of the problems later. So the three Pythagorean identities are sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1, tangent squared theta plus 1 is equal to secant squared theta, and lastly, 1 plus cotangent squared theta is equal to cosecant squared theta. Let's take a closer look at this first Pythagorean identity, but before we do that, let's take a look at this right triangle. One of the first formulas that we learn about right triangles is the Pythagorean theorem, which states that a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, where c is the hypotenuse and a and b are the two legs. So we're going to use this right triangle to verify this identity, which states that sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. Well, sine of theta would be the opposite over the hypotenuse, or a over c. So sine squared theta would be a over c squared plus cosine squared theta. Well, the cosine of theta would be adjacent over hypotenuse, or b over c. But again, we're going to square it because it's cosine squared theta is equal to 1. Let's go ahead and square these fractions, a squared over c squared plus b squared over c squared equals 1. Here we have a common denominator, so we have a squared plus b squared over c squared equals 1. But we just stated earlier that a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared. So we have c squared over c squared is equal to 1, which does verify that identity. And these others can be done in a similar fashion. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple problems. Here we're given that cosine theta is equal to 3/4, and theta is in the fourth quadrant, and we want to determine sine theta and tangent theta. We can use this first identity to determine the value of sine theta since we're given cosine theta. So this states that sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta, or 3/4 squared, must equal 1. So let's go ahead and solve this for sine theta. 3/4 squared would be 9/16. Now subtracting 9/16 on both sides, I know that 1 is 16/16. So 16/16 minus 9/16 would give us 7/16. So to find sine theta, we'll take the square root of both sides. And we have sine theta is equal to plus or minus the square root of 7 over the square root of 16, which is 4. Now, we have to determine whether we're going to take the positive or negative value of sine theta, and that's why they told us that the angle is in the fourth quadrant. If we're in the fourth quadrant, the y-coordinate would be negative, therefore sine theta would be negative. So our final value for sine theta is equal to negative square root of 7 over 4. Next, to find tangent theta, we can use this identity since we know both sine theta and cosine theta. Tan theta is equal to sine theta, which is negative square root 7 over 4, divided by cosine theta, which is given as 3/4. But we could multiply the top and the bottom by 4 to obtain the value of tangent theta as negative square root 7 over 3. Okay, let's take a look at another problem. Here we're given that tangent theta is equal to negative 5/3, where theta is in the second quadrant. And we want to use the identities to determine secant theta and sine theta. Again, there are several ways to determine these function values, but right now we're just practicing using these identities. So in order to find secant theta, we could use the second identity, which states that tangent squared theta, or negative 5/3 squared, plus 1 must equal secant squared theta. This would simplify to 25/9 plus 1 equals secant squared theta. I know that 1 is 9 ninths, so 9 ninths plus 25 ninths would be 34 ninths. Taking the square root of both sides, secant theta equals plus or minus the square root of 34 over the square root of 9, which is 3. Next, we're in the second quadrant. Remember, cosecant theta is equal to r over x. The x coordinate would be negative here, therefore cosecant theta is negative. Now this last one can be a little bit trickier. We want to determine sine theta, which is equal to 1 over cosecant theta, but we don't have cosecant. But we could find cosecant using this identity and then just take the reciprocal of that. So let's go ahead and do that. What we could do is find cosecant theta and then take the reciprocal to find sine theta. So let's try using this one. We'd have 1 plus cotangent squared theta. Remember, cotangent theta is the reciprocal of tangent theta. So if tangent is negative 5/3, cotangent would be negative 3/5. So we'd have negative 3/5 squared equals cosecant squared theta. Okay, to save a little bit of time, this would be 9/25 plus 25/25. So that'd be 34/25 equals cosecant squared theta. Taking the square root on both sides, we have cosecant theta equals square root of 34 over 5. Again, cosecant involves y. Y is positive in the second quadrant, so we're only going to take the positive value for this function, which leads us to sine theta would be the reciprocal of this, or 5 over the square root of 34. And rationalizing this would lead us to our final function value of 5 square root 34 over 34. So quite a bit of work on this problem. Let's see if we have time for one more. Here we're given the point negative 2, negative 4 is on the terminal side of theta, and we want to find the exact values of the six trig functions. So what this tells us is that x is equal to negative 2, y is equal to negative 4, and remember that r squared is equal to x squared plus y squared, which means that r squared is equal to negative 2 squared, or 4, plus negative 4 squared, or 16. Well, if r squared equals 20, r would equal 2 square root 5. So doing a little bit of review here, we know that sine theta is equal to y over r, so we'd have negative 4 over 2 square root 5. Now this can be simplified and also rationalized to obtain the function value of negative 2 square root 5 over 5. Well, next we know that cosecant theta is the reciprocal of sine theta, so the reciprocal would be 2 square root 5 over negative 4, and again this simplifies as well, so we have negative square root 5 over 2. Next, let's find cosine theta, which is equal to x over r, so negative 2 over 2 square root 5. Again, we'll simplify and rationalize. So here we're going to have negative square root 5 over 5. And the reciprocal of cosine theta would be secant theta. So the reciprocal of this, we'd have 2 square root of 5 over negative 2. This simplifies nicely to negative square root 5. And we have two more. We know that tangent theta is equal to y over x. So negative 4 over negative 2, that would equal 2. And then lastly, cotangent theta is reciprocal of tangent theta. So reciprocal of 2 would be 1/2. So here we use several of the reciprocal identities to help us find these function values. Okay, I think that's enough. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you and have a good day.